Welcome to section 10, Cluster Troubleshooting. This section we will take a look at Hadoop Troubleshooting Part 1 and Hadoop Troubleshooting Part 2 and also some key points. Welcome to our session on Hadoop Troubleshooting Part 1. In this section, we'll be looking at what are the common failures, let's say for a name node and a data node, and how we can solve them. This list is very long. It's not possible to cover all cases, but some of the common cases we will be touching upon. Things go bad, right? Just like any other infrastructure or software problems, things can go wrong with Hadoop as well. So in this section, we will look at some of the common issues, excluding hardware failure. For example, I will not be talking about what if motherboard fails or a RAM fails. Those kind of issues. We'll be looking at mainly our issues concentrated mainly to Hadoop operations. So name node failures. Why a name node could fail? As I said, excluding the reasons for hardware issues, name node disk full. Disk full is not a hardware issue. It's more about how you have set up the sizing of the disk for the name node metadata. Check for metadata disk utilization. So how you can solve that if you have name node disk full issue? What you can do is you can either do a manual checkpointing. How you will do manual checkpointing? You will put the name node into safe mode and execute the command sdfs dfs admin hyphen save namespace. So you can refer to our previous video where we have done this command. Name node could run out of memory. Make sure name node have the heap size rightly configured in terms of how many blocks we have in the cluster. Accordingly, we should be configuring the heap size. So the rough rule is for approximately 1 million files, you should have 1 GB of memory, or simply 100 terabyte of disk space in your cluster could be addressed by 1 GB of memory on the name node. So you have to do sizing accordingly. Name node slow response time. If name node is slow to respond, obviously we have to check whether we have given the right kind of hardware in terms of CPU and memory. Other than that, important thing is insufficient number of handlers. Name node handlers are kind of threads which are part of the name node service which will be handling your requests. So you need to pump that up. Handler counts. By default, the value is set to 60, but you can increase that value according to the size of the cluster, but it should never be greater than 220. So if you are interested, how is 220? The formula is 20 into log to the base 2 n, where n is the number of nodes in the cluster. Name node not starting up, corrupted image, permission issues, host resolution errors. So you have to check for all these things. Name node may not start due to disk full also, because your disk is full, it's not able to do checkpointing, it does not have enough space to do the checkpointing. So how you can solve this? You can copy or mount the metadata disk to another node and you can do a manual checkpointing and then copy the data back. Name node taking very long to start up. So you can increase the name node heap. For example, what happens over a period of time when the name node is running and your secondary is out? So your edits will keep on growing. But next time when you restart the name node, it might not be able to upload the entire thing into memory and do a checkpoint. It will take very long time. So what you can do, you can quickly bump up the name node heap size, start the name node, let it do checkpointing, and then you can reduce the heap size later on if you have constraints on the memory on that particular node. And obviously, make sure your permissions on the directory are correct. Now, similarly for data node failures, disk full or bad blocks. Make sure the disk is not bad or marked read only. Not able to connect to master, data node is not able to connect to master. Obviously, first thing, you should make sure your DNS reverse lookup is working and master is reachable. So if in your DNS you have not configured reverse lookup, then the name node will fire a shutdown command. So this is a default behavior in Hadoop too. I can change that by setting in sdfs-site file, I can disable name node reverse resolution. So I can say to the name node, do not verify the IP of the data node which is connecting to you by doing a reverse lookup. But by default, it will do reverse lookup. Make sure your version file has the correct cluster ID. So if your data node does not have the correct version file means in terms of cluster ID, the name node will fire a shutdown command on the data node. Data node performance. Again, you can increase handler count. By default, the handler count is very less, which is 10. You can increase your receivers and you can do correct sizing in terms of how much disk you put on a data node. So I should not be putting too much of data on one data node. So when I say data in terms of, I mean too many disks on a data node. So there's no point in having 100 TB on one data node, right? It might take very long time for decommissioning, and it might also be a bottleneck in terms of processing if my network is limited on that node. Make a good habit, right? It's very important to watch logs for each daemon for its operation. Not only when things go bad, also when things are working fine, so that you are sure what's going on, how the services are working, and that way it is easy to spot any anomalies. So if you are watching logs continuously, so you can quickly figure out and point to any anomaly if there is an error. Understand JVM tuning, OS optimization, network layout, multipathing, and its impact. It's very important. For example, on network, understand what are jumbo frames, what are the conditions each device in my network path should support a jumbo frames, which is 9000 MTU. Understand OS optimizations, what kernel parameter or sysctl parameters on Linux will have what kind of an impact on Hadoop. Let's say huge mem pages, why we disable them, what is the role of swapping, JVM tuning, understand JVM tuning, how having a larger JVM can increase your pause time, but having a very small JVM can increase your frequency of GC cycles. So there will always be a trade-off. So to summarize, we looked at some of the common name node and data node issues. And similarly, we can narrow down on issues related to any daemon in the cluster. So first thing is, have a good habit of reading the logs.